men in the world, the one who brought women in this world, is the one who brought me in this world.
She, I'm just comfortable with all, because that is me.
You think this is the devil's work?
Yeah, and I have the confidence that is the devil's work.
Yes, I follow what we do.
Some people want to rape me.
Apostle is lucky to be alive. Many others like him were killed.
My name is Apostle Dallan Ruki. I'm an intersex with a part of female and part of male.
Samana nyole toka nene tugimane pok naneno nyaka ne korono boba et anyola ngone tabu.
It is so painful. God has brought me from far because I could be killed, and my mother kept me and protected me not to be killed.
Koro kano nyuol nyathi magat to ne ji ok mor.
Ai ngima aneno kidet.
Before Dolly Atieno's time, traditional birth attendants in rural Kenya witnessed the murders of intersex babies.
Kano nyuol nyithindogi anyuola mane gi ai ok ne dwargi nikech ne gineno ni gin hawi marach. Koro ne ginegogi, ni sandogi, ni ketogi ei dero, ni turo rabuon e wigi.
She knows just how fortunate Apostle was to have been allowed to live.
So they would just die of hunger?
Yeah.
Apostle's mother chose to save him, but she couldn't protect him from the judgment of others.
During the time I was trying to play with my fellow children, they were saying that you are an abomination, you are not a human being. I was despised and rejected. Then my mother told me that you were born differently. And it was God's work, so there's no way I could change it, and that's the way I give back to you.
In God's temple, you are.
Today, Apostle is the preacher at this Christian mission. His followers have come to accept and even revere him for who and what he or she is.
I'm just comfortable with all.
They're going to be right no matter what they say.
No matter what they say, because that is me. Yeah.
So, with Apostle's permission, I'll use the masculine pronoun. He hasn't always been so open about being intersex. For many years, he kept it secret.
Thanks to the Almighty God, we shall sing this song.
But came out to his followers in 2012.
I stood here in the mission, then I started telling them, you know, me, I was created this way. I didn't see them being amazed of that. There were some people were just telling me that we knew it even before we thought. We were just waiting for you to confirm it.
Despite the traditional religious views that prevail here, his congregation see him as a miracle rather than a freak.
Has your mission helped you find acceptance and love?
I feel loved, but with this condition of being intersex, it's very difficult in some areas. Sometimes you feel loved, but sometimes if you think of you have memories of the past, you feel even to cry.
But Apostle is loved in church and at home, where he lives with his family.
I'm tired.
I did.
I was cooking. Thank you.
Ninaona ni nzuri. Tena nampongezi Mungu kwa kumumba hivyo manake. Apostle akivaa naona kama iko tuko na furaha naye manake. Hata nguo inakutosha hivyo katika hiyo kuishi kwetu naye. Sioni ugumu wowote.
Intersex people are born with variations in sex characteristics, including hormones and genitals, that don't fit typical definitions of male or female bodies. Intersex, or the third gender, is not recognised legally in Kenya. In fact, it's viewed as a curse.
What was it like for Apostle growing up as a child?
Ongenga manedware kodika ya wui kakuyuka keni wui ya wui okdware tokoda okanyiri koni nyiri bekoni iwui we biro butwa koro onge kamane enti koro anima obedo kode samoro ta obedo kende toka onge adhi kata wuoth todonga donga odwa kanyo tedo mana kende to chieme udi mano imane otimore ne.
In the small village where Apostle grew up, life was intimate, and he couldn't hide his physical differences.
As children who are born near the lake, we were going for bathing together and we removed clothes. My mom was trying to stop me not to go with them. Always they were threatening me and teasing me. Some people want to strip me off, some people want to rape me.
And intersex is something that needs to be prayed against.
It is very hard for a poor man to go to heaven because a poor man will always complain.
Pastor Kennedy Odeni doesn't think Apostle is fit to be a church leader.
The devil can interfere with God's creation.
You think this is the devil's work?
Yeah, I think so. And I have the confidence that devil's work. Let me ask you a question. When you remain female and male, where do you want to live? How do you want to identify yourself? Which kind of sex do you want to be around? Because I cannot trust you with my wife. She cannot trust you with her husband. So where do we place you?
In the name of Jesus, we pray and believe. Somebody say amen.
You have heard of Apostle Darren Ruki?
Yes. And it's a man. And a woman. It's not normal. God created male and female.
Yeah.
Donge yao. Kuse kuse idwani idwani mondo wabonye. Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, I come against fear. In the name of Jesus.
Pastor Odeni also suspects that Apostle is a charlatan.
Very close to your church here is Apostle Dalan Ruki, who says he is intersex, who leads a church. How do you feel about this person? What do you...
Number one, I'm not very sure whether he's intersex or no, but I've heard him proclaim. Dalan Ruki says that is miraculous, just like Jesus. And he uses this to win favor from people. I think he's using that state to lure people to follow him or to make followers. So I don't agree with him.
Are you saying that you're not sure if he is intersex or not?
I'm not sure.
As you love me, I love you too, because we are all equal before.
My God is God of success.
If you are lacking something, God is here for you.
Pastor, they have come to kill me.
The pastor we spoke to said he didn't believe you were intersex. He suspected it was an act to attract followers, that you were pretending to be intersex.
What he's saying is just because he wants to see, and this is the privacy of somebody. Why don't women also show their private parts to prove that they are women? Why don't should men not to prove that they are men by showing their private parts? Why should I prove that I am intersex?
Curiosity about Apostle's body is something he spent many years trying to avoid.
You did your best to look like a man.
Yes, I did my best to look like a man. I tried to change my style of walking. It was very, very terrible to me because it is you're living like somebody who is in a jail.
He says the worst time of his life was adolescence.
Starting to experience menstruation period.
Menstruation?
Yeah, menstruation period. That was the thing which was tormenting me, and my breasts coming.
You made a couple of suicide attempts, is that right?
Yes. Yeah. During the time my foster father told me that, you know, you are not my child, and I want you to leave this home and go wherever you want to go. And if you don't want, then kill yourself. So, I didn't know where to go. I was still young.
Thank you, Lord, very much.
Despite his inner turmoil, Apostle eventually gained a reputation as a gospel singer. In a world of costumes and performance, Apostle probably felt safe exploring his feminine side. But as his fame grew and his videos hit YouTube, he experienced a backlash.
The people who are selling my DVDs were telling me that people are asking us, this person is a gay or is a transgender or who is he?
And is being gay a problem here in Kenya?
It is not allowed in Kenya.
But you do think that homosexuality is a sin? It is bad?
To me, I know it's bad because even biblically it is bad. But I don't blame those people who are doing it.
In Kenya, being gay is considered a choice, an illegal choice. Being intersex is seen as a medical condition. And while still stigmatized, it's not against the law. Apostle came out publicly after finding acceptance at his mission, where he offers shelter to others who are struggling.
I thought to get a place where I can have some people with problems like me.
So you were an outcast, yes. And you have created a community for yes. other outcasts.
Yes, other outcasts. Orphans are here, widows and widowers, and the mentally sick and people with disability. They are still needed in the society, despite the rejection they have passed through.
I don't feel discriminated amongst you.
Amen.
Because we are all equal before God. Amen.
To his congregation, being both man and woman has given Apostle almost mythic status.
Blesses me to God.
Now more than ever, they see him as a holy man, capable of bestowing blessings.
God is the creator who creates everybody, and it's the one who creates the intersex.
Against all odds, Apostle has carved out a safe space for himself and his followers.
I would just like to see you standing up.
He's preaching tolerance and acceptance, and it's having a wider impact.
Before thy presence I stand.
Bring to you my soul.
In 2016, protesters in Nairobi called on the government to introduce laws recognizing a third gender, neither male nor female. It's a fight that has the support of an MP who also knows what it's like to be ostracized.
The legal recognition of intersex persons is very important, because if you're not recognized by law, then you don't exist.
This is a photo of myself, the official portrait when I was running for Member of Parliament in the last election. My connection with this is because, of course, I'm a person with albinism, and I know how is it to be different in this society.
It's the second highest honour in the country because of my contribution.
Isaac Mwaura is a tireless advocate for minority rights, but not all minorities.
It's actually for your own.
He says it's wiser for intersex people not to align themselves with the gay rights movement.
I think I would not want to engage in that.
I don't think our society is ready for that. I think it would work against our mission here, that I can tell you for sure.
Mwaura is optimistic, but anticipates a long fight for recognition of a third gender.
The churches and other pressure groups are very, very powerful in matters of politics and social aspects of life, because we are 80% Christian society. But we expect resistance. I would be very surprised, to be honest, if the proposed bill just passes without any rancor. I'm sure there will be.
In a country where being gay is a crime, recognition for intersex rights won't happen overnight.
Always attract a crowd like this when you go out? Do you?
Yes, I do.
In the meantime, Apostle doesn't try to hide his intersexuality.
Neutral.
In fact, he flaunts it.
What about this one? See it?
2 to 20.
It sometimes strikes me that in Kenya, coming out as intersex would be a lot easier than coming out as gay or transgender.
This is very different to the way things used to be, yeah?
Yes. Yes.
Asanteni.
Sawa, karibu tena.
May God bless you so much.
Sawa, sawa.
Irokamano uriyawa.
Irokamano.
Irokamano.
Sawa, karibu.
E papka wanjo mamanyo ngapiko. Osamoro tich koso no ato. Wane odo ni kwedi mo pap mo dikwedwa ka
mano ngawa.
Nyasaye mar nyiseche yaone gi wanga yo maka wuok ka to gweth mari mondo olre kuom gi ching moro giriem mitokni kowuok. Tich bed gima gitiyo ni. Akwayie nying Yesu Kristo mja Nazareth.
Amen.
Nying Yesu Kristo yudu duong.
Amen.
Nyasaye polo mundo gwedu yawa.
Amen.
Thank you, thank you.
Oya bimoche.
There's no denying apostles' role in chipping away at the stigma around intersex people.
You're a real local celebrity.
Yes.
It's the decades he spent feeling ostracized and abused that have encouraged him to reach out to others like him.
Oh, welcome, 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 all guests.
Welcome, 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 our guests.
Oh, welcome, 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 all guests.
Welcome, welcome.
Just having apostle visit can be life-changing for an intersex person like Maureen.
Welcome, 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 our guests.
Neighbours who usually shun her see the celebrity holy man paying her a personal visit. They want to join in welcoming him and take a step closer to accepting her.
Dak ni chwe kata manon lemo moro de koronga to sachama kata ni chwe guok moro de koronga to saniga.
Maureen knows her life will improve after Apostle's visit. Her gratitude is overwhelming. Every Sunday afternoon at the mission, Apostle holds a talent show. He encourages everyone to join in. All the misfits and outcasts who've become family.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
And he's invited Maureen along.
There are some intersex who are coming behind me. If a better foundation can be built for them to feel good and to know that they are also human being like others, a situation where they will not be discriminated, I will be more excited.
Most intersex people still live in the shadows. But a generation ago, this would have been impossible.
My life right now, I see it's good. I feel good because I'm living a life which is me.